Everyone in this arena has a money stake in one of our famous couples. Rooting section number one has its money on Bill Cullen, host of Three on a Match, and his wife, Anne. Rooting section number two backs composer-singer Chuck Woolery and movie actress Joanne Plumb. And rooting section number three is betting on Alan Ludden, host of Password, and Betty White of the Mary Tyler Moore Show, as we play the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletales. And here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Convy.
Thank you, everybody. Welcome to Tattletales, especially you, Joanne. As you know, our studio audience is divided into three sections, each one backing one of our celebrity couples here. And every time one of our stars wins some money, it is divided among their rooting section. So let's get ready to start that dividing, shall we? Ladies to the rear. Fellas, have a seat out here with me. We're coming right back. Don't go away.
Unpredictable.
He is going to blow a standard inner tube until it explodes.
Unbelievable.
Well, we're home tonight.
Unforgettable.
Are you an actor?
No.
Boy, that sure isn't the voice for it, is it?
The legends live on. Buzz Till Dawn. Tonight, starting at 2 a.m. When you're up again, one too many times.
Makes you feel kind of stodgy, doesn't it?
Only on Buzzer. Let's play.
Okay, we're back, ready to start. The fellas are going to start out here with me. At first, of course, is Alan Ludden, and backstage is his lovely wife, Betty White.
There she is. There we are, guys. How does she look in there?
She looks beautiful.
No, she doesn't.
Yes, she does. She looks beautiful. You look nice, too, Alan. It's
okay,
nice
to have
you. No, she doesn't.
And next to them, of course, is Chuck Woolery and Joanne Flew. There they are.
Get your hair out of your eyes.
No, he can't see. He just said that. He said, fix your hair, but he really can't see you.
No.
Unless you can see in the back of it.
I can't see
it. No, I don't think you can. And next to you, of course, is Alan Ludden and his lovely wife, Anne.
Yes, thank you. Great.
I said Alan.
Terrific, Bill.
Well, I tell you, I have to tell you, I have been doing this all day.
We aced it. We did it, yeah.
Now,
did.
They did this before the show. You said, now remember, I'm Bill, and he's Alan, and I said it.
Yeah, I'm Bill.
He fell right.
Well, he's really Bill
Let's
Cullen.
Pretend like we haven't done it all. No. And next to Chuck and Joanne is Bill Cullen and his wife, Anne.
Right.
There you go.
Sorry. I thought that was my lovely wife, Bert Parks.
No.
Sorry.
See, Alan, you got me all ready.
I'm sorry. I did that. I confess, friends.
I'm new at this, and you aren't picking on the new board.
I really did.
All right, ladies, we're going to get back to you in just a moment. We're going to cut you off from sight and sound. Bye.
I'll see you, Ryan.
Okay, let's see if I can do this. Fellas, I'm going to ask you some questions about your wives and your lives together. When you have an answer you think your wife recognize, press that little red button in front of you, will you? Right. I'll only take one response, so you have to be first.
Don't miss it, Bill.
Speaking of first, here is the first question. It happened while you were dating. Anybody have a story for that? Chuck! All right, Chuck, tell us about
interesting
it.
Story. We had a blind date, our first date. I thought she was Sally Kellerman, because they were both in MASH, and I'd never seen her before. Now, the interesting thing was, she didn't want to go out with a hillbilly from Kentucky, right?
Uh-huh.
She'd never seen me either. She was right. So the thing that changed the whole thing around was we went to a place for dinner that night, and I ordered her for a drink, very fine champagne. I can't mention the name of it because you're not allowed to mention names, but it was That's right. He knows. And she decided at that point that I was not a hillbilly from Kentucky and she'd take me.
Okay, now what are you going to use as a one or two word clue then?
Yeah, champagne.
Champagne is a one word clue worth $100 for your winning something. Okay. Okay, let's bring on the ladies now. Ladies, we have asked the fellas a question and we have a clue. If you recognize your husband and can match his story from the clue, sound that little signal in front of you. Here we go. Here is the question first. It happened while you were dating. And the clue is champagne. Let's see.
Joanne. Oh, we got two.
Who was first? Joanne was first. Tell us about it.
Yeah.
Well,
easy, baby. Low profile.
Is that my best one? Uh-huh. We had a blind date that David Ladd had set up, and Chuck didn't want to go with me because he thought I was somebody else from the movie MASH. He just didn't think she was his type. Anyway, and I thought he was a hick. And I...
Yes?
So we went out to dinner, and as soon as he ordered me Dom Perignon, I said, he's for me.
That's what I said, Bob.
Not a class.
That's what he said. Thank you, dear. We'll get back to you in a minute, ladies. Okay. Next question coming up. Okay, fellas, ready to go. Here is the next one. Dom Perignon, indeed.
Yeah.
Same question. It happened while you were dating.
Oh, yeah. Same question.
Damn. You see that?
There you are, Bill.
My story is not as romantic as that. My story is simple and to the point. I was coming out here weekly from New York, and my wife and I were dating, and I would say, why don't you come up to the room of my hotel and have a drink, and then I'll take you home. And she said, it would look bad. So I had read the Douglas Fairbanks autobiography, and I stay at the Beverly Hills Hotel, and there's a back door. And if you know how to park on Crescent and leave your lights on, you can walk in and come up the back way. Uh-huh. And then I'd take her down and out the back way and into her car, and the people at the hotel never knew the difference. And my clue is I'm going to get heck from home.
Earth calling Bill.
I'm sorry I have to use two words, but huh?
Hotel.
I am the one that had the assignation. I am the one who will give the clues.
Yeah.
I was doing this while you folks were in the peanut gallery.
Oh,
door is the clue.
Back door is the clue. It's a two-word.
That's
word.
One word. You'll be sorry.
Back door is one.
Is that one word or two words, Mr. Producer?
Back door's got a little hyphen in there.
That's two words, the man says. Okay, $50. Don't give it away. Here, let's bring on the ladies. Okay, ladies, we have another question. We have another clue. The question is the same question. It happened while you were dating. And the clue is back door.
Haunt me. I think Bill's probably referring to the fact that when he commuted and he stayed at the Beverly Hills Hotel. And
yeah, go ahead, Tony. Tell him a bit.
The easiest way to get to his room was through the back side entrance because I could park the car on Crescent Avenue and walk in that way.
That's so exactly right. And that's worth $50 for you. You're moving something. Thank you. All right. At this point, Ben and Ellen have zero. Joanne and Chuck have $100. Ann and Bill have $50.
Yeah. Okay.
All right. Now it is time for a tattletale quickie. So reaching up here, we'll get the tattletale quickie. Each one of these questions is worth $100. Ladies, I'm going to ask it of you, but don't give me the answer until I ask it to. Girls, I'm going to give you a choice of three compliments. Which would you most like to hear? A man says, you're one of the most attractive women I've ever met. A woman says, you're the best friend any woman could have. Or a child says, I wish all mommies could be like you. Let me say it again for you. Which one of those compliments would you most like to hear? A man says, you're one of the most attractive women I've ever met. A woman says, you're the best friend any woman could have. Or a child says, I wish all mommies could be like you. Go away and think about it, ladies. We'll come back to you in just a moment. All right, Alan, which one of those do you think Betty would most like to hear?
Well, now, if you had something about what a dog says, there'd be no choice. But now, between children, women, and men, I'll go with the man. She'll say she'd prefer the compliment from the man.
Okay, she'd like to hear that one. All right, let's bring on Betty. Betty, which one of those three compliments would you like to hear?
Oh, I'm afraid there's just no contest. I like boys best. I think a man should say yes.
No contest at all, huh?
Uh-uh.
You know, Alan said the one category we didn't have here was a dog.
Well, that would be first if they did say that.
Why is that? Do you have a dog you talk to a lot?
Have several I talk to. I talk to all kinds of animals.
Right. She talks to anything with a leg on each corner.
Yeah.
All right, thank you, Betty.
Not as often.
Okay, Chuck, how about Joanne? Which one of those compliments
tough.
Would you most like?
Boy, they're all lovely compliments. That's really
yes,
tough.
They are.
And see, I'm going to have to rule out the children, I think, because we don't have children. So it's between a man and a woman, and being a good friend is a good one. I think I'm going to go with a man, too, because every woman likes to know she's attractive.
Yeah. All right.
I'm going to try to
Yeah. Okay, the question is, which one of those three? Yeah. Let's bring on Joanne. Joanne, which one of those compliments would you most like to hear? From a man who says you're the most attractive woman I've ever met, a woman who says you're the best friend any woman could have, or a child who says, I wish all mommies could be like you?
Well, I just finished a movie of the week with a little boy that I fell in love with. Aww, and so I would probably say I wish that a child would say that to me.
Okay. Now
that's all right, darling. I don't mind, because that's sweet.
Tell her what you said, Chuck. Bill. Nevertheless, no
later
score
on,
there,
though.
Tell her what you said, Chuck.
Yeah, I thought that you would like to be attractive all your life because you're so vain and everything, you know.
Oh. Did you really?
I'm just kidding,
Chuck,
darling.
Chuck said that. I didn't say that, Joanne. Chuck said that.
Is she
Thank
mad?
You. I'm sorry, dear. No score there. Okay, Bill, how about Ann?
Well, there's no question in my mind because that same story I told earlier about the back door,
mm-hmm.
last time he threw her out, the hotel detective said, you're the most attractive woman I've ever found. No, and I think, like most women, I don't know, I think she would want the compliment from a fella about being the most attractive woman.
Okay,
and she
is. Let's see if she agrees. Yes, she is. Ann?
Yes.
Which one of those three compliments would you like most to hear?
I think the man saying that.
That brings us to halftime at this point. Betty and Alan have $100. Joanne and Chuck have $100. Ann and Bill are in the lead with $150. Okay, gentlemen, change places. Fellas to the rear. Ladies, come on out of here. While we're changing places, we'll break away for this message, but we're coming back in just a moment. Don't go away.
The 50s were cool. The 60s were groovy. The 70s were happening. And the 80s? Well, they're just like the 50s, 60s, and 70s. Experience it all. Ride the Buzzer Time Machine. Saturday starting at 8.
Okay, we're back. As you know, our studio audience is sharing the winnings of our celebrity couples. But let me add this. If your rooting section is backing our winningest couple at the end of today's show, we will add as a bonus $1,000. Okay, no. All righty, we have the ladies are out here with me. Let's see if your fellas are situated correctly. Gentlemen,
yes.
Are you comfortable? Everybody all set?
Oh, it's terrific, Bill. Very. Coffee,
got your earphones. Don't talk at once. I can't hear anything. Now, everybody say hello.
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 Now, cut them off. Goodbye, fellas. Oh, I love that.
You love that kind of
I really
command,
like that.
Don't
I,
you?
I like to cut them off when they're talking. That's even more fun.
So do I.
Okay, ladies, I'm going to ask you questions now about your husbands and your lives together. When you have an answer you think he'll recognize, push that button in front of you, okay? I'll only take one response, so you got to be first on the button. Here is the first question. Not yet. Not yet. Oh, Joanne, I don't know. Here we go. A birthday you will never forget. Woo! And you are very fast.
Yes.
You've
well,
got a quick
he
rise.
Gave me a surprise party that just ended all surprise parties. He hired a Circle Line boat, which goes around Manhattan Island.
Oh,
this
that's
was
wonderful.
A total surprise to me. Had 75 people. He had an orchestra. He had arranged the food.
Wow.
He had arranged everything. It was just
wow.
absolutely fabulous.
What a wonderful idea.
So, let's see.
Now, we need a one or two word clue.
Well, let's try. Now, what's the clue again?
A birthday you will never forget.
Let's try boat.
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 One word clue. Boat.
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 Okay.
Okay. Let's not give it away. Let's bring on the fellas. Gentlemen.
Oh, yes.
We have asked the ladies a question, and we have a clue. Here is the question first. A birthday you will never forget. And the clue is boat. Tell us about it, if you will, William.
Well, Ann was streetwalking in Venice during... used to be a boat trip that went around Manhattan Island. And Ann had a birthday, and I luckily chartered the boat and had a bunch of people down and told her I was going down a dock to take pictures of the thing I had been in. And it was a surprise party with all her relatives and friends of mine. Also, we put her on and we took her around the island, and that was her birthday.
That's right. And that's exactly what she said. So what a terrific idea for a party.
It really is.
Did anybody have a little too much and fall off, or you'd lose them in the East River, wouldn't you?
I did right before the check came.
All right, thank you, fellas. We'll get back to you in just a moment.
Bye.
Okay, ladies, next question coming up. Get ready. Same question, a birthday you will never forget. Betty, you are...
Well, again, it was a surprise party that I'll never forget. It was a rather momentous birthday, and he thought it was kind of a momentous birthday before a momentous birthday. And he thought, well, this one she won't expect a surprise party. And he made it so casual that I thought I was just going to have dinner with my mother and my husband, and I were just going to a restaurant. That poor fellow went out and bought me an outfit to wear and casually had to con me into wearing it. And I got to the place, and they conned me upstairs with a whole long story, which I won't go into. And... all our good friends were there. It was. I kept running into two people at a time until it was a whole beautiful thing. Oh. It was the most complete surprise I've ever had.
Okay.
And only four of them got drunk and fell overboard. But, you know, otherwise.
Funny, and you weren't even on the water.
No. So,
I wonder how they did that. Okay, what are you going to use as a clue, Betty? One or two words.
Restaurant. Okay.
Restaurant. One word.
I'll take it from you, babe.
All right, that's what your section wants. Let's bring on the fellas. Gentlemen,
yes.
We have another question and we have another clue. Actually, we have the same question. A birthday you will never forget. And the clue is... restaurant. That's close. Who was first? Alan was first. All right, Alan, tell us about that one.
Well, I thought a while ago she was going to press the buzzer. I gave her a surprise party, too. It wasn't on a boat. It was at Chasen's restaurant here in Los Angeles, and I fooled her pretty good, and she walked in. My only concern about the whole thing was that since it was a surprise, I wanted to be darn sure she had on something that she'd be pleased to be seen in. So I not only had to get her a party, I had to get her a new dress.
Let's see how we stand. Joanne and Chuck have $100. Betty and Alan have $200. Ann and Bill are in the lead with $250. Okay, we'll be back with more Title Tales in just a minute. Don't go away. Coming back for the finale.
Where do you catch TV with class?
How do you do? I'm going to be in New York a while?
The answer is in black and white.
Once you kind of relax, settle back, and enjoy yourself.
Buzz Till Dawn. Tonight, starting at 2. Let's play, baby.
Okay, we're back. Yeah. We're going to play a tattletale quickie now. Fellas, I'm going to ask you the question. Don't give me the answer until I ask for it. And each correct answer is worth $100. And we have a close game. Anybody can win. Here we go. Fellas, in your bachelor days, which turned you on the most in your bachelor days? Short skirts, tight slacks, or plunging necklines?
Oh, my.
In your bachelor days. Bachelor days. I'm making that definite. Which turned you on the most? Short skirts, tight slacks, or plunging necklines? We'll get back to you in just a moment.
I know. It's a shoe-in.
In his bachelor days, which one of those three turned Alan on the most, Betty, do you think?
Yes.
Yes. Okay.
I tell you, Alan has had so few bachelor days. He was married for years and years and years to a lovely lady who has since passed away, and then he's been married to me, so he hasn't really had a lot of time on his own. But... and his free time in between, let's say. I'd say short skirts.
Short skirts.
I would say.
Oh. Let's bring on Alan and see. Alan, which one of those three turns you on the most? In your bachelor days, that is.
I've been married all my life, so it's no different. I haven't changed. That's a terrible choice.
Really?
I think, with a very slight difference... I like the plunging neckline. What did she say? What did you say?
That. Tell them what you said, Betty.
Well, I said from just judging by your eyeballs, I would say short skirt.
Well, I wouldn't touch that. You go ahead.
No, you better not touch it. Anyway, thank you, Alan. There's no score there. Sorry. Joanne, how about Chuck? Which one of those three in his bachelor days turned him on the most?
The smartest idea.
Really?
No, because the same as Betty said, all of them, probably.
Well, you have to make a choice.
Holy D, do I have to?
Yes, because the question is, which turned you on the most? So what do you think most he is most attracted to?
Oh, I think I will say tight slacks.
Okay. Short skirts, tight slacks, or plunging necklines? Yes, if you know, tell her, because she wants to know. No, you're going to go, what are you going to go with?
I think I'll go to short skirts.
You're going to change it now? No complaint if she's wrong, right? You're gonna short skirts is what you're gonna say. Let's bring on Chuck. Okay, Chuck, which one of those three will it be? Short skirts, tight slacks, or plunging necklines?
Absolutely no question about it. In my mind, tight slacks.
Tell them what you said, Joanne.
I didn't know, but I would say tight slacks.
Yeah.
The audience said, no.
Hey.
Oh. Short skirts.
Oh, get them by the throat, honey.
Your rooting section picked short skirts. I'm sorry. Chuck, no score.
A lot of trouble.
Thank you. Okay, Ann, how about Bill? Which one of those three turned him on most as a bachelor?
It's an absolute shoe-in. I know exactly what he's going to say. He's going to say short skirts. He likes tight pants. But he much prefers short skirts. And the cleavage, he wouldn't have married me if that had turned out.
All right, let's bring on Bill. Okay, Bill, which one of those three will it be? Short skirts, tight slacks, or plunging necklines when you were a bachelor turned you on the most?
When I was a bachelor. It's another way of asking me whether I'm a leg man or one of those other three choices. Short skirts, dude.
$50 for your rooting section. We add $1,000 to that for a grand total of $1,350. Okie dokie, we'll be back in just a moment with more Tattletales. Hang on right after this message.
Up next, people are actually rewarded for telling lies on To Tell the Truth. Then just try to guess how these folks make a living on What's My Line. Stay tuned.
Okay, we don't have much time. Today we gave away a total of $1,650 to our studio audience. Congratulations to you, and congratulations to our winner, Ann and Bill Cullen. Great time to say so long until next time. Our studio audience will be sharing the secrets and the winnings on Tattletales. See you then. Bye-bye, everybody.
This is Jack Clark speaking for Tattletales. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.